In section 4.3, we will start with the angular momentum of the electron in hydrogen atom. Let me first review a little bit the angular momentum. As we came to know in the solution of the Schrödinger wave equation, that n, which we call as the principal quantum number, it is having a role only in calculating the energy of the electron. While in order to determine the quantum states of an electron, quantum states of an electron, we need the orbital quantum number L, and this will give us the states of the electron. Now, as we know that the electron is revolving around nucleus, and we found that there are different orbits and there are different orbitals. The quantization is due to the orbitals. There are the different series that we are obtaining are due to the quantum states, which are the angular momentum dependent. Now, the angular momentum, which we write as capital L, is R cross P, where P is the linear momentum, and this is the rotational analog of this, means the momentum in rotation. So angular momentum, in simple words, I can say that it is the momentum of a rotating body. A body which is moving in a curved line is angular momentum. And this angular momentum, let me first a little bit discuss the translational and the rotational analogs. We know that P, the linear momentum, is mass time velocity, which is mv, and the angular momentum will then be the rotational analog of mass. So the rotational analog of mass is the moment of inertia, and the rotational analog of linear velocity is the angular velocity. I know that the rate of change of linear momentum we call is force. Similarly, the rate of change of angular momentum, if I write it like the rate of change of angular momentum, will be, as I replace P by L, here the force will be replaced by its rotational analog, which is tau. So angular momentum is very important for a rotating body, and our quantum mechanical quantization is due to this. So we will start with the classical relation, which is L R cross P. But here we know that now our angular momentum, which is a physical quantity, will be now treated as an operator. Similarly, the linear momentum will also be treated as an operator, while this one is also an operator. So we are entering quantum mechanics, and I will write that L equal R cross P, and this is a vector multiplication, so I will follow the IJK notations here, and R is X, Y, and Z, while P is PX, PY, and PZ. So I will now do this multiplication, and I know that this will be YPZ minus Z and PY, because Z, PY, then it will be an I minus, then it will be XPZ minus Z PX and J plus I will cancel this row in this column. So xpy minus ypx, and this will be mzx's. Now I know that L is a vector, so L is equal to Lx and I plus Ly and J plus Lz and K. So I can compare this side and this side, and this will give me that Lx is equal to, this will be ypz minus zpy, while Ly will be the next component. So it will be this minus, if I do multiply, then I can write it in positive like this, zpx minus xp and z here, and lz, this will be equal to xpy minus ypx. So this is, we will have to note here that there are certain variation is like this, that x goes to y goes to z, and it is cyclic. Then z will go to x, and similarly px will go to py, and then it will go to pz, and then again this will go to px. Similarly, Lx will go to Ly, will go to Lz, and this will be back here. So I can see here that Lx goes to Ly and Ly goes to Lz. Here is Y, here is X, so here will be Y. And this Y goes to Z, and Z should go to X. Similarly, PZ going to PX, then PY, and so on. These are true. Z will go to X, then Y. PY will go to PZ, and PZ will go to X. And this is true in this direction as well, that if I write Lx here, then the very first it will go to Ly, and then it will go to Z. Similarly, Ly, so it will go to Z here, then Z, then Px, and like this. Z will go to X, and then Y, and then it will go to Px then. So all these means these are cyclic in nature, and we will have to keep in mind that Px, the operator, it was minus I h bar curly y curly x. So Py will be in component form minus I h bar curly y curly y, and Pz will be minus I h bar curly by curly z. So we will have to keep this thing in mind, while r is x and I plus y and j and z and k. So we will have to a little bit review the commutation relations. Like, we are having two operators A and B. These two operators, this is the commutation relation, such that this will be equal to AB minus BA. Now, if this commutation relation is equal to zero, we will say that these two operators are commuting each other. And if this will be non-zero, then these two operators are not commuting with each other. Now, what is meant by this? When two operators are commuting, it means the order of their measurement doesn't matter. Like this operator, if we measure this operator first and this second, and here this first and this second, then their measurement or their order of measurement are not disturbing the system for each other. And those two operators are called commuting operators. If their order will matter, like one operator disturbs the system for the other operator, then we will say that these two operators are non-commuting operators. When two operators are commuting operators, then they will have the same set of functions. And here we will say the same set of eigenfunctions. When two operators are non-commuting, they will have different sets of eigenfunctions. So we know from our previous knowledge that if I take the Ri with Pj, so this will be equal to ih bar delta ij. When I will be equal to j, then we will have 1 here, and this will actually cause this equal to ih bar. And I will briefly discuss this one, but first write this one, that if I find the commutation of Ri with Rj, then this will be equal to 0. If I find the commutation of Pi with Pj, then this will also be equal to 0. These are commuting operators, such that this I and J are actually X, Y, and Z. Now look here. If this is Rx, Rx means X, and this is Px, so I and J are now the same, and when I and J are the same, then the Kronecker delta will give you 1. So their commutation is equal to I H bar. Now when I and J are not the same, for example, when Ri is Rj here, Rj is Y and this one is X, or this one is X and this is Y, and vice versa, so this will be equal to 0 because they are commuting, but X not commuting with Px. Similarly here, if I write that whatever the ij values are, they will commute. Like if I do X with X, or I do X with Y, Y with Z, and vice versa, and they will be equal to 0. Similarly here, if I write Px, this will be with Py, or Px with Px, or Pz, or whatever they are, vice versa, then they will also be equal to 0. They are commuting operators. So when two operators will commute, it means they are having same set of eigenfunctions. And with this, we will now start with our angular momentum. That our angular momentum is L, and it is equal R cross P. And if I expand this, then this is R P sine of the angle between the two. So if I consider this thing, that if a particle is going in a circle, so this is center, this is the moment arm which we call R, and this is the direction of velocity v. So m times v is the velocity. So if a particle is of mass m, then its momentum is mv. Now this is p mv. So we have here is this will always be tangential to it, and this angle will be always equal to 90, and this angle will make this angular momentum the maximum in a completely circular orbit, which will be r times p, because the maximum value of this sine theta is plus 1. It oscillates between plus 1 and minus 1, and the direction of it, when it rotates like this, so this will be the direction of angular momentum, and if it rotates like this, this will be the direction of angular momentum. So when we will have to think of this, that this is rp sine of the angle. So when n can be 0, n can be 0 when r is 0, rp is 0, or the angle between r and p is equal to 0 r pi. So that is means not only this magnitude is important, but the angle is also very important here, which will determine the magnitude of this angular momentum. So we now start with the having all that in mind. We now start is we know all these commutation relations. So let's start that whether these components of angular momentum are commuting with each other, like we are having the commutation of these. But we will have to keep in mind that the angular momentum is all of this type, like R and P. So we will have to check that whether they do commute or not. So let's start with the very first one and try to find the commutation of the Lx with